Let's look at Sura 5:43. Musin Khan, but how do they come to you for decision while they have the Torah, in which is the decision of Allah? Yet even after that they turn away, for they are not believers. Yusuf Ali, but why do they come to thee for decision when they have law before them, or the Torah? Therein is the command of Allah. Yet even after that they would turn away, for they are not people of faith. Pickthall, how come they unto thee for judgment, when they have the Torah, wherein Allah hath delivered judgment? Yet even after that they turn away. Such are not believers. Sahi International, but how is it that they come to you for judgment while they have the Torah, in which is the judgment of Allah? Then they turn away after that, but those are not believers. Let's look phrase by phrase at these four different translations. But how do they come to you? But why do they come to thee? How come they unto thee? But how is it that they come to you? Who are they that this verse speaks of? They are Jewish people, as we shall later see. And who are they coming to? It is clear from this verse and the context it is Mohammed. Come to you for decision. Come to thee for decision. Come they unto thee for judgment. Come to you for judgment. These people, the Jewish people, are coming to Mohammed for a judgment of some kind, while they have the Torah, or the Torah. When they have their own law, Torah, before them. When they have the Torah. While they have the Torah. These people have the Torah. This is how we know they are Jewish, or that we're speaking of Jewish people. In which is the plain decision of Allah. Therein is the plain command of Allah. Wherein Allah has delivered judgment, in which is the judgment of Allah. This tells us the Torah, which the Jews had with them, contained the decision, command, judgment, the word of Allah, or the word of God. Keep in mind, Surah 5:43 does not say, they came because their Torah was corrupted. Does not say, they came because their Torah was corrupted. They came because their Torah had been changed. They came because the original Torah had been lost. They came because the Jews did not have Allah's guidance. Yet even after that they turn away. Yet even after that they would turn away. Yet even after that they turn away. Then they turn away after that. This phrase accuses the Jewish people of turning away even after something. This can mean one of two things. Even after that can mean even after asking Muhammad's judgment and opinion. Even after that can mean even after having the Torah, the Word of God. If you think interpretation one, then you really think the Quran has elevated rejecting Muhammad's judgment to being more offensive than rejecting the Torah, the Word of God. Because when you appeal to two sources, we always appeal to the greater source second. As example, you may not believe me, but you will believe the Quran. And I would not say, look, if you don't believe the Quran, then believe me. That doesn't make sense, and that's not how people try and make their argument. So if you think interpretation one is the correct meaning, then you are making Muhammad's judgment, his decisions, higher than the Word of God, the Torah. You are making Muhammad's judgment and decisions the final authority. Keep in mind, this does not say the Quran. It says Mohammed's decision and judgment. Unless you somehow think the Quran contains Mohammed's judgments and decisions, which creates other problems for those of you who call yourself Muslim. Look again at what the text says. Come to you for decision, come to thee for decision, come unto thee for judgment, come to you for judgment. It does not say, come to you, Muhammad, to hear what the Quran says. Think about that. This is really important. They are coming to Muhammad for his judgment and his decision, not for what the Quran says. If you call yourself Muslim, you cannot think Muhammad's judgment, his words, are higher than the word of Allah. So you cannot think interpretation 1 is correct. So therefore, interpretation 2 is the only acceptable meaning. This phrase therefore accuses the Jewish people of not following the Torah, the word of God they had. This only makes sense if the Torah was still the word of God when Muhammad made this revelation. For they are not believers, for they are not people of faith. Such are not believers, but those are not believers. So those who did not follow the Torah of Muhammad's day were unbelievers. This means that those who followed the Torah during Muhammad's time were believers. I find that interesting. Let's summarize what this means. Muhammad said the Torah they have was the word of God. Muhammad did not say the Torah they have was corrupted, or false, or full of errors. The Torah that existed in Muhammad's day was therefore the Word of God. The Torah has not been changed since Muhammad's day, so it is still, therefore, the Word of God. But if the Torah was and is the Word of God, because it has not been changed since Muhammad's time, why do those who call themselves Muslim today claim it is corrupted and false and not the Word of God? Does this not call the Quran a lie? Remember, Sura 5:43 proves the Torah we have today is the Word of God. It was the Word of God when Muhammad lived. It has not been changed since then. It is the same. If it was the Word of God when Muhammad declared it the Word of God, then it is still the Word of God. Those who turn away from the Torah are unbelievers. If you call yourself Muslim, realize your Allah affirms the Torah he sent, and those who reject it are unbelievers. If you attack the Torah, if you say it is corrupt, if you say it is corrupted, if you say it is not the Word of God, you are an unbeliever. You do not submit to God. So respect the Word of God, the Torah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.